This art is making both a splash and a statement at Fife's saltwater wading pool. It's where Fife's little ones learn to swim. The teaching pool gets a lot of use, and every so often, the city has to drain and repaint it.
They were looking for ways to incorporate more public art, and the pool was ready to redo the bottom of the floor because it was wearing out.
So Fife's year-old public arts commission got involved with the local high school art students to paint a mammoth mural on the bottom of the pool. A huge task, but the teens loved every minute of it.
It was really fun, actually. I never expected to be able to paint for 8 hours straight and still enjoy every minute of it. So I'm definitely looking forward to do something like this in the future.
Danielle is the youngest member of the Arts Commission. Before she and her fellow Fife High Art Club members started painting the pool, they took great care to make sure their vision was just right.
They were really excited. I mean, from the get-go, they were really excited. And they got together on their own during art club time after school and came up with a design and then had several sketches ready that we pass on to the pool.
The mural was going to be more than a fresh coat of pool paint. It would also serve as a way to ease the worry of small swimmers afraid to put their face in the water. That's why the young artists made sure there were no paintings of angry sharks below.
We definitely did not want anything scary. We wouldn't want the kids not wanting to swim in the pool because of dangerous creatures or something that would frighten them. So we wanted to keep something on the more lighthearted side.
We want it to be inviting and have something fun to go underwater and look at, since most of them, we like to call screamers, don't want to go under the water. So friendly murals and things to look at just make the pool more inviting and less timid of, oh my goodness, there's this huge body of water and they want me to put my face in.
So yeah, a lot of it comes from kind of a Nemo-ish, kind of Disney-ish, cartoonish, kind of tropical, happy creature theme.
But there's more to Fife's public art program than just what's underwater.
Would you look at the bust one more time?
That's photo artist Julie Watts shooting another young artist, Elizabeth Deisler, as she practices drawing in classical realism at the Merlino Art Center in Tacoma.
Those kind of people, when I find out about them, they're so inspiring and it makes a big difference for me. And I thought, everybody needs to be able to get a little glimpse of a dream follower.
Her work is a series of portraits featuring artists who are following their dreams. Like the students on the pool project, Julie was chosen by the Fife Arts Commission as one of the five finalists to provide artwork for the city to display. She's turning the tables a bit by making other artists the subject of her photographs.
I'm honored. I don't talk much about what I do, and I don't want this to be a vain sort of thing, like I'm on the spotlight. I speak because I want other people to go through this curriculum and learn the classical art.
Here are some of the other finalists. These works will be in city parks and other public sites, such as the Fife Public Library, for up to a year. The Public Arts Commission could choose some or all for Fife's permanent art collection. In addition, people living in Fife will get to select one community choice artwork to also stay on permanent display.
I'm really thrilled to wow everybody when they see what it looks like.
In Fife, Laurel Potter for Rainier Country.